Today I am bringing you another product review video with ketone tests. So this one has to be recorded much like the other ones I've done over a multiple day span because of being kicked in and out of ketosis. So I will go ahead and show you the products that I tested and the results. Okay, it's 8 o'clock and I'm going to test my ketones. I don't know if it's too early to test my ketones, but I'm gonna test it because I'm hungry and I wanna test my first product for the day. Whoa. So I just finished a fast, so that's why I'm so high, but that's crazy. So I'm gonna test my first product. I want to try these ones. I used to eat pure protein bars all the time, and then I found out that maltitol was no good for you, and it has maltitol in it. That's the list. So it's 200 calories for one bar, 18 total carbs, and 8 sugar alcohol. So it's actually 10 carbs for one, which is more than I would like, but I think that's just this flavor. I think there's other ones that are less, but I want to test the maltitol in these and see how it is. So this one is birthday cake. This is what it looks like. If you like that, like artificial birthday cake flavor, you would like these. I actually do like it in some instances. It is more of like a taffy texture. It's got a little crunch to it, maybe because of those things, but I really like this flavor. This is definitely not for everybody, because if you don't like that fake kind of birthday cake flavor, then you would not like this. But I'm going to go ahead and eat the rest of this. Oh, I did want to note, it is very chewy. So like I've given my grandma one of these and she really doesn't like it because she feels like it gets stuck in her teeth because it does have that taffy kind of texture. But I mean, I'm kind of used to it because of protein bars, like a lot of protein bars being that way, but just so you know, it does have that kind of real chewy texture and it gets stuck in your teeth, or at least doesn't come out right away. But I'm going to eat the rest of this and then I'll test my ketones in an hour. Okay, it has been an hour since I tested my ketones, where I was at 2.4. I'll go ahead and test again. Whoa, gosh, that dropped me a lot. I don't really think it's necessary to test it in 2 hours. So I'm probably gonna wait 3 hours after I finish that bar to see where I'm at before testing another product. But obviously that's gonna kick people out of ketosis because that's too big. But I'll wait 2 hours and test again. And so it'll be a total of 3 hours after I had the bar to see if my ketone level stops decreasing. Okay, so I'm gonna test my ketones and see if I could test my next product. I have had 2 eggs and 2 chaffles this morning, but that was 2.5 hours ago. So I'm gonna test my ketones now and see what they're at. Wow. That's really high. Okay, so I'm going to test my first product for the day. I'm going to try for the very first time Lolli'S Granola. This one is peanut butter macadamia. The nutrition is for 28 grams. It's 110 calories, 10 grams of fat, 3 total carbs, 1 dietary fiber, so 2 net carbs. So I'm going to measure out 28 grams and show you what that looks like. Okay, so this is what 28 grams looks like. It's really oily, I'd say, because they're like stuck in these clusters. I've never tried Lolli'S Granola because it's really expensive. I wanted to give it a try just to test my ketones and see if it's worth the price. I think they're like, I don't know, $10 or $11 per pack, but I'll go ahead and give this a try. This one is peanut butter macadamia, and you can really smell the peanut butter in it. It has a really nice flavor to it. It has a nice soft chew. It reminds me of a granola bar. I wish I had got a different flavor than peanut butter because there are so many big chunks of peanut butter and I think macadamia. It's not the way that classic granola is where it's crunchy and kind of hard. but it has a really nice flavor and texture to it. I could see this being really good on yogurt. So I'm going to go ahead and eat the rest of this one, and then I'll test my ketones in an hour and 2 hours. Okay, it has been about 1 hour. I think I'm 5 minutes early, but I'm gonna go ahead and get my ketones started testing. Wow, it went up. That's awesome. I know a lot of people really love those the Lolli'S granola. Again, all I had today was 2 eggs and 2 truffles, my zero carb truffles. But that was 2.5 hours before I had the granola. So I'm gonna test my ketones in another hour and see if it's gone up or down at all since then. Okay, it is now 2 hours after I had the Lolli'S granola, so I'm gonna test my ketones again and see if I've decreased since an hour ago. An hour ago, I was at 2.5. Wow. So that Lolli's granola, it was probably the peanut butter in the Lolli's granola, but either way, the Lolli's granola definitely increased my ketone level. So now that I'm at a 2.7, I'm going to have this good fats bar. So I think I've had the peanut butter good fats bar. This one is cookies and cream. I don't think I ever tested my ketones when I had the other good fats bar. This one's 190 calories for the bar, 13 grams of fat. 13 total carbs, 8 fiber, so it's 5 net carbs, 1 gram of total sugar, 9 grams of protein. So I'm going to have this, see how the flavor is on this one. So it's pretty broken. I've had it for a little while, but it's actually like white chocolate coated, so let me try this. So it has little crispy things on the inside. The chocolate should be like more chocolatey. It's a little chalky and a little salty. But the inside is like just really lacking flavor. The white chocolate coating is really good, but you can't try it. You can't taste the white chocolate coating when you have like a bite of the whole thing. The white chocolate coating tastes like cookies and cream, but it's a very small portion of the total bar, so you don't really taste it when you have like a bite. The middle part really does leave something to the imagination. Like it's kind of light. And then it has that crispiness and it's a little salty. It's really not sweet at all. And it's not chocolatey, although you would think it is chocolatey. So, anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and eat the rest of this and I'll test my ketones in an
Okay, so
hour.
I was silly and I wasn't recording, but this is what the reading was. It's 2.4.
So it did go down by 0.3, so I will test my ketones in another hour, which would be 2 hours after finishing the bar.
Okay, it has been about 2 hours since I finished that good fats bar. My last ketone test, let me see what it was. My last ketone test was a 2.4. So let's see what it is now. Wow, that's weird. It went down and then it went back up. Really crazy. Okay, guys, that is all I have for you today. If you were surprised by any of the results, please drop me a comment in the comment section. I would also love to hear if you have any suggestions for products to test, maybe like something that you have regularly in your diet or something that you're thinking about purchasing but not quite ready to make the purchase. I would love to try any new products, and I like testing my ketone levels so that I can figure out what's best to incorporate in my diet. So, if you're curious about anything, I would love to hear your thoughts. So please drop me a comment in the comment section. But that is all I have for you guys in this video. I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.